exciting because, again, we get to talk about fashion.
Fashion. something girls like. But, you know, these days, the men are so into fashion also.
Right. I like that.
I also like it.
Yeah.
But, you know, some people, they think about it as, if a guy's into fashion, he's gay.
Not necessarily.
My husband, Mark, is into fashion.
Mark's not gay. He just sleeps in.
He's not gay, but you know, he tells me, okay, wear this, wear that, don't wear this, don't wear that, you know, and he's very particular, well, of course, about the way I dress, especially in show business. Sometimes you have to dress in a certain way,
right?
Because you have a show or you're in the province or you're on stage. But I consult him a lot in my fashion.
But I like it when men have an opinion. Like,
I do.
Should I wear this or this? It all looks the same. Should I wear this or that? Whatever. So it's nice when they have that.
And I like it. If you don't ask, sometimes they say, oh, you know, that dress makes you look a little short. I like that.
Yeah.
You really look good in that dress. You should have like 10 made of that. I like that.
I
like
that
because it's not usual for males to do that. But these days,
it's so acceptable.
They are so into it.
Sometimes, and the men dress so much better these days.
I know. And sometimes even more than we women, even more than the girls, they're so into themselves.
Yeah, they're vain.
You know, they're vain.
Yeah. I knew someone who, like, when he'd work out, he'd be staring at the mirror the whole time.
Okay, you know what they say? Those who are like that, they're usually gay.
Yeah, I think he was.
Yeah, and then I have many friends, oh, I like this guy. You know, I see him in the gym and I really have a crush on him. And then, you know, he just looks at himself the whole time.
Think twice, huh, when you see them at the gym, especially if it's like LA, SF. Chances are he'll be checking out another guy, not you. But, you know, the difference between all the other guys and all the other designers and our guest tonight is because this is like fashion for a really good cause.
Exactly.
Yeah, and I really like that because it's their way of giving back. I mean, they're so successful already in their fields that they want to help and they want to pay it forward.
That's true.
I really admire that.
And I also like the idea that people who are already big in the industry share their talents and it shows that they're not insecure.
Right. I know. That's exactly what I told Randy. Mm-hmm. It's so nice that you guys are very secure. Mm-hmm. Randy Ortiz.
This is Randy Ortiz, yeah.
Where you guys are and you're even willing, you're like even wanting to help out and willing to help out the people that
or
you
just starting
think
out.
Should deserve recognition.
That's true.
Yeah. So that's quite admirable.
Martin said something about that. I was telling Martin Rivera, I was telling him that I admire him because he's not insecure about his talent and he says he wants the new talents to also come up and shine.
If anybody guests on Martin's show, you can be sure that he would share the limelight and even willingly like say the best things and help the person. That's just the person he is.
That's true,
which is why he's still successful today.
So Martin is somebody big in his industry and our guest tonight is somebody also big in our industry.
The
fashion industry
just made a huge name for himself.
Okay, so when I saw him,
so huge, it's like a major road
exactly.
in Manila.
So when I saw him, like, I was a little shy and he had such a pretty face.
Diba?
Yeah, and when we were talking in the dressing room, I kept staring at him and I said, oh, I'm sorry I keep staring because he has such a pretty face and I just kept looking at it.
Exactly.
So he looks like a doll.
Yes. But she said, what did you say again? You said it's nice to finally
put a face
in the name. Yeah,
yes.
Because we've heard of his name and I admittedly have never met him.
Yes, in person.
Until tonight.
Yes.
Yeah.
And then she said that she is happy that she's finally meeting him in the flesh tonight.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I had no idea. I said, does anybody know what he looks like?
So they
and
can.
We had a good description.
Yes, just
pretty
in case.
Boy.
Yeah. Just in case he comes in and we're in the studio and he comes in the gate.
Yeah.
Or something. Mm-hmm.
So tonight, ladies and gentlemen, we will introduce you.
Yes.
Yeah.
In a little while.
To our really special guest who has a really good cause together with other designers in a little bit. So don't go anywhere. Don't miss this.
said, she said, and tonight it is our honor to have with us in the flesh. He's somebody that we always hear about and read about.
Always. Okay.
But one of our biggest fashion designers in the country and internationally, please welcome JC Buendia.
The baby face with great skin and a cute dimple.
I know. Okay, let's just stare at him. See? It's so cute. Do you get conscious?
Yes.
You're shy. Are you really shy? Or do we make you shy?
No. I've joined a singing contest.
No!
Really? Who did you partner with?
Every week we have a different
singing
partner.
Oh. Where is this? Is this like a regular TV show that they're looking for?
2 years ago, I joined Celebrity Duet.
Yeah, Celebrity Duet. And then?
Oh my gosh, everybody so who joined that.
I landed second place.
Really? What did you sing? What was your winning piece?
This was after Tessa won or before Tessa won?
After Tessa won.
Can I just tell you, Tessa had, she said, a surge of fame after, mm-hmm. which still like lasts until today.
Yeah.
Do you have the same experience? Because like now everybody, maybe before only AB recognized you and now like ABCD, like
E.
all know who you are?
E. Yeah, so even in Mega Mall, people greet me and say,
"That's so nice,
JC. Gawin mo kami ng barong." Like that.
Uy, nako.
So what is your winning piece?
Oh, I sang a lot of Neil Sedaka songs and.
Mm-hmm. We want to hear a sample, JC.
Yeah, come on. Anyway, you were second place.
Yeah, you were second place, naman.
Na.
Okay,
just
lang yan.
One line or five lines. Okay, one line.
Neil Sedaka. What are the Neil
what
Sedaka song?
Okay,
songs?
What song in particular?
I sang.
I watched Neil Sedaka in San Francisco. I can't think of a single song. That
No,
he sang "Laughter in the Rain."
Okay, one line.
I love that song. Okay, we'll help you.
It's not one of my best.
I hear
laughter in the rain.
Walking hand in hand with the one I love.
Okay. So tell us about actually, kami lang naman ang gustong kumanta.
Tayo na uto, di ba?
So how were the rehearsals for that? Did you rehearse every day? Your partner was given to you?
It's different every week.
We can choose our own partner week.
So who did you choose?
Okay, who did you choose?
We think of concepts and
okay, who were your favorite three partners? Top three.
because
the way you got along,
I have this secret fantasy of being a rock star. So my favorite partners were Joey Henaroso.
Oh, it's okay. ID.
Jet Panga.
Okay. This is a celebrity with another celebrity.
Yes,
isn't it supposed to be a celebrity with a non-celebrity?
It's a celebrity with a singer.
With a real singer.
So Jet, hi Jet, and Joey.
All J's, huh? JC, Jet,
and Joey.
Parang ano.
Diba?
I got to sing with Randy Santiago.
Randy Santiago. Wow. Hi, Rand.
Hey, Randy. Galeng, you know what, Jace? I would have never thought that that's your secret dream. Because you seem so shy and you're not the same. You're a rocker, so like... And you seem so reserved.
What kind of songs?
Bring me to a video, and I won't pass the microphone.
Direct. Oh. Ilagay mo yung minus one.
Wait, so when you rehearsed with them, was it actually rock songs? Did you sing rock songs with them?
Yeah, I
soft rock.
Yeah, like... Pride.
Mm-hmm. What did you wear?
Black.
That's what I'm excited about every week. I make my own costume. I make the costume of my partner.
Right. Oh, I wish we were real. Like,
okay, out of the contest, how often would you make an outfit for yourself?
Oh.
is it often? Maybe once a week or maybe?
No.
The most often you made something for yourself? Because it was a long stretch, right?
Yes. But normally I would neglect my own clothes.
Because you're too busy making clothes for other people. Right.
Is it like that for designers? Because I know some dentists, they neglect their own teeth.
Seriously?
No, because they're afraid.
Ah.
Yeah.
That's not good.
Yeah, they're afraid. They're afraid to have anything done to them. But you know,
anyway. Look at Giorgio Armani. He always comes out at the end of the show wearing the same navy blue t-shirt.
Oh, see? Oh, yeah.
He probably has like 100 of those lying in his closet.
Yeah.
Right?
Or maybe that's his favorite for a show.
No, I heard he has a navy t-shirt in silk, a navy t-shirt in
oh, I love that.
Or maybe that's his favorite lucky color.
What's your favorite color?
Baby blue.
Oh, baby blue.
Yeah, that's why he's in blue. Yeah. You know, before Martin always used to fly in a black shirt. Doesn't matter what color, what design, whatever, it has to be black shirt. So some people have like good luck, whatever. It's like, diba? Mm-hmm, like Pacquiao will wear a certain.
I'm a black shirt.
Yeah, so or like you, navy blue.
Baby blue.
Lucy. She
yeah.
loves blue.
Mm-hmm. I always wear black, but it's a uniform for most fashion people, but I like blue.
Mm-hmm. When did you start getting interested in the industry?
When I was in high school.
Where did you study?
UST High School.
UST.
What did you take up?
I took a fine arts after.
Was already, yeah.
No, but in high school, I didn't know what a fashion designer was. I used to do a lot of sketching Disney princesses.
Wow. High school was in?
UST High School.
Also, yes. Okay.
And then I read the book Scruples by Judith Grant, and that's how I learned about fashion.
So that was only in high school and then college.
From the book alone, then that's when it awakened your desire to.
Yes, that's it gave me the realization that
this is what
I want to do, and from then on, I didn't.
Stop.
Yeah, I didn't stop. I went to the library and read books about Chanel.
Oh, that's
Yves Saint
Laurent.
Serious. Okay. Yeah.
Really?
And then
I got so fascinated by
fashion.
Mm-hmm. By their lives. They're from Madame Vionnet, from all those designers.
Wow, you went through history.
In fine arts in college, is there like a month that it's only all about fashion designing?
We had fashion design subjects.
Okay.
And then every year we have an actual fashion show at the Arc of the Century of UST.
And you used to join that?
And we yeah.
Was that and you used to win?
No, it's
just a, like
the,
a show
the teachers just give
just
us grades. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's just
so was this
but you used to get great grades, I'm sure.
Yeah.
A collaboration.
Did you have like a certain style at that time, like certain color, play of colors? Did you have a certain, you know, preference to whatever, or you just went with the times?
Oh, when I was younger, I was greatly influenced by the TV shows then, Dynasty. So
okay.
It was all about flashy colors, puff sleeves.
Yeah, puff sleeves.
That's right.
And then bright colors.
And then yes.
So in school, that was a collaboration with your class,
or the individual,
or yeah. Or a small group?
No, individual.
Oh, individual.
Like you just make one gown or one dress or
we make a capsule collection. Like,
oh, really?
Like five dresses.
And
then?
There's a whole show.
And then people model it?
Yes, the students. We have classmates who are very reed thin, so we get them as models.
Okay, so let's say these are the clothes of JC Buendia, then five of them, five models. And then somebody else with another five models, like
yes,
that?
Yes, like
or,
that.
Oh, okay, not even the same five models to be used throughout.
Oh, no, they model for everybody.
So do you remember what kind of clothes you showed?
I showed a lot of draping at that time because I didn't know how to make flat patterns at that time, so I just drape on the mannequin and then just sew it from there.
Do you have any of those clothes from back then? You could have a museum.
No.
No.
I haven't kept any. But I kept one. I joined the Young Designers Contest, and then there were 10 designers from Manila who were chosen to represent the Philippines in Paris.
Wow.
And the theme back then was a day in a castle. So,
and since you were used to drawing princesses since you were
so
younger.
So I made a carousel-inspired gown.
A carousel-inspired gown. Yeah. It's like it really like buffon. Mm.
Yes, with horses. With horses.
Cinderella.
With horses.
With horses appliqued on the skirt.
Oh, wow. That sounds so interesting. Yeah. So that probably goes down as one of your favorites in history. Where is it? Is it in your shop right now?
I've kept it in our house. So.
Oh, so you've kept it?
Yes.
Oh.
I want to talk more to JC, how he really got started, like how it like went on to how did he become known, mm-hmm. and how he was able to like make his name, yes. a household name, mm-hmm. when we come back.
Okay. So she said, we'll return still with JC Buendia. On she said, and QT was telling us that we're going to know more about how JC Buendia started and how he made his name.
Right.
But during the gap, JC told us that
in his own shy little way.
Okay. He tried suming it ng konti, di ba? We kept talking and talking. Well, we were in the opening. We were talking about how men are so into fashion now, and sometimes people think of it as, their feminine side or they being gay. JC was telling us, he said, do you want to know how you can tell if a person is gay or not? And I said, most definitely.
I didn't even want to wait. I said, now.
I want to know now. Okay, and we waited for the show to come back so we can share it with our audience.
Yeah.
So,
telltale
kung
signs.
Meron po kayong mga boyfriend na medyo
nagdududa
kayo ngayon, malalaman niyo na. Okay, JC.
No, a real man would look into your eyes. But a gay man would look at your eyebrows.
Oh my God! Okay, can you look at my eyes? Okay, then look at my eyebrows. I mean, how can you tell if the person is? What if yung eyebrows niya mababa? What if yung eyebrows? But how can you tell if the eye is really looking at your eye or up?
No, it's just like this. A guy will say, "Hey, you got beautiful eyes," or "Hey, your eyebrows need to be blocked."
No,
like that.
It's like if you meet a dentist, you can tell right away because you're talking to somebody
and they're staring at
and
your
they're
teeth.
Staring at your teeth. Okay, but the eyebrows and the eyes are very close to each other, right?
Well,
okay. What else? What other tips?
No, 40% of my clients are men, and they're quite vain.
Really?
Okay. Especially now
is it
that
harder. Are the men more difficult than the women, or women just win that race hands down?
No. Men could be more difficult.
Really?
Especially because suits are more. It's more tailored to the body and. Nah.
But it's tailored. I mean,
it's more.
Yeah, it's got a fall right.
They're meticulous. Yeah, okay.
Yes, yes.
And
it's harder to alter a suit than a dress, right?
Yes, yes.
Because there's the lining and there's the.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I mean, I think women's clothes are so. I think they're easy to make. You can adjust it easily.
And you can play more with the design.
Yes. Yes.
With men's suits.
You can be more creative.
You know,
men's clothes are like...
Details are very, very small. Mm-hmm.
Would you rather make a suit or a barong?
Both are interesting. Mm-hmm. With a barong, you can play with embroidery. Like for Manny Pacquiao...
You made his, diba, the sauna?
Yes. He wanted a map of Sarangani, but when embroidered on the barong. But when I looked at the map of Sarangani, it
medyo mahirap.
Or hindi maganda yung shape.
It wasn't distinctive. So I suggested fish embroidery.
Sarangani.
So
okay. So he compromised. Did you also make Jinky's gown?
I did some of her gowns, but I think she had to choose on the day itself what to wear.
What about the other congressman for 15th Congress? Whose barong did you make aside from Pacquiao's?
Secret? Is that a
no,
secret?
No.
I remember not too many.
Okay, so let's talk about how.
Like the women. Do you remember any of the women?
I did for most of the wives and.
Of the guys that you made barongs
for. So most of the spouses.
So maybe later on we can talk about the personalities and some little bits of stories about them. But we want to know how exactly you started, how you made your name, how you got big.
From UST, where was the transition there?
Where did you work
how
first?
How did you get your name
After
out?
College, I worked as assistant designer to Cesar Gaupo.
Right.
He's a big name in RTW.
Yes.
And then after that...
How was it working with him?
We were poles apart. But
okay.
I mean, his designs are very sensual, mm-hmm. and mine are very sedate.
mm-hmm.
But I've learned technique and the passion for the craft.
Yes.
And it was a good time to be working with Cesar because. During that time, they have the FDG, that's a Filipino designers group mm-hmm. that's composed of the big names in the industry like Ino Soto, Gang Gomez, mm-hmm. Joe Salazar, and every year they have a big show.
Yes.
And you're witness backstage to what's happening. You can see all the gowns up close.
How long did you work with Cesar?
I've worked for him for 7 years.
Okay, and then after that?
Then you broke away and you started
and
your
then,
own
shop? No, not yet. I also had a stint with Kire Boutique.
Mm-hmm. Kire.
So
with Dobie, after Dobie?
After Dobie. So Dobie. With Kire, I was doing a lot of tailored clothes. So that's the time my tailoring skills were honed.
Mm-hmm. Because you got known first for your tailoring skills, right?
Yes.
Like if you want the perfect suit, go to JC Buendia.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
In fact, a lot of artistas were having their suits.
Yeah, especially
done by you.
During awards nights.
Yeah,
I get commissioned a lot for
how
suits.
Your name got out there.
Mm-hmm.
So you majorly through the tailored suits.
Yes, yes.
Right? Through actors.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Would you say that the actors had a huge part in getting your name out there, or the designers that you worked for and you worked with?
Showbiz helped a lot.
Showbiz helped a lot because
I get a lot of clients from the provinces who. Mm-hmm.
Okay, who in showbiz in particular did you dress that seemed to get you a lot of income? Is there anyone in particular, or just everyone altogether?
Oh, of course that would be Chris Aquino because mm-hmm.
she is
the biggest endorser.
She's the biggest endorser in the Philippines for the past how many years?
Yeah, so if any people read her tweets and her star texts and people start asking me for clothes similar to what they see on her.
But if they do want something that what Chris had worn, do you ask like would?
No, I don't repeat.
Would you ask Jackie's first cousin? Yeah, would you?
Yeah. Hi, Chris.
Hi, Chris.
I don't repeat the design.
So you just
variate it. Mm-hmm. I use a different. Yeah.
But they say gusto ko yung suot niya nung blah 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 itong episode, and then do you remember everything you've made for her?
Yes.
Yeah, so they say, gusto ko yung sinuot niya sa this and that show, and then ito yung kulay, and then they sort of describe it, and then you'll know.
Yeah. I have a photographic memory.
Oh, wow. Good for you.
Okay, and I'm sure that's helped a lot.
Yeah, especially with the singing.
So you draw for this new customer, and then you sort of make it like that. And then do they like the color? She likes a lot of her back showing, right?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So do they also choose the color and the material, or you're the one?
Most of my clients just give me you their full trust. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh my gosh. You know that photographic memory will work really well, especially if you see a design you like, you just go home, doom.
Have you had that since you were young?
Yeah, sometimes I would wake up and...
With a vision.
Yeah, and then just draw really? What I saw in my dream.
Oh, you dream design?
do you dream in color?
Yes, yes.
Wow, amazing.
Oh my God, I'd love to dream design. I wouldn't know how to...
I dream in color, but...
I dream in color.
You draw. Yeah. Well, we'll try
well,
to draw.
So much for that. You know, we'll have more with JC when we come back. And I want him to let the world know, because we started out in the Philippines, but let them all know how they have been so generous enough to give back.
And earlier we were talking about JC and how JC Buendia and how he is going to share his talent with everybody else in the Philippines who would like to be maybe someday as big as him.
Yeah, so from the little I know, JC Buendia, who's the president of this
FDCP.
FDCP, which yeah. stands for Fashion Designers.
No, it's a Fashion and Design Council of the Philippines.
Oh, that's what I was going to say.
Yeah, because...
Me also, I was just testing you.
No, because our members are fashion designers, accessory designers.
Oh, also accessory designers.
Yes, and homeware designers. So it's not limited to apparel.
Fashion designs, right.
Okay, yeah. What does homeware designers mean?
Like Anton Barreto, he makes things for the home. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Right.
But all...
like bougie.
Yes.
No, furniture is different.
Furniture.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
But bougie
just,
also...
Just home accessories.
Home accessories. Such as like...
So not just with
vases,
material, but
candles.
Accessories like you can put candles. Things
like bed sheets, no?
No. Yeah, you can.
Or things that you can put on desks or accent pieces.
Yes, yes.
Ah, interesting.
Like Kenneth Kabunpue. No,
Kenneth is, yeah, furniture.
Well, it's furniture. About yeah.
Okay, so tell us about that. How did you come about this?
They
is
have
this
teamed
the first time?
Up with Congressional Spouses Foundation Incorporated.
Yes. Last year, I got elected as president of FDCP.
Congratulations! Which is why Randy said we should
which
interview
came
you.
After the inauguration of President Noy.
Mm-hmm.
And during the inauguration, would you believe there was a shortage of piña fabric? And really? I was talking to the suppliers, and they said because they stopped manufacturing piña, yeah. And some of the farmers have stopped planting piña.